What's good, future millionaires? We back with another banger. I'm December DeMarco, Fortune 500 marketer, and I'm here to share my insights of the market with y'all to hopefully help y'all become better informed investors, man. Salute to y'all for pulling up on the channel. Make sure you hit that thumbs up like button for the YouTube algorithm. We got, you know, a few things to discuss. You know, I want to talk a little bit about market psychology and what to expect when things aren't heated up like you expect it to. So just a quick prediction. I think we're going to see Shiba Inu take off pretty soon. We're in that fifth month from October where we seen our last breakout, which was 5 months from that breakout that we seen during May. So I think it's that quiet before the storm period right now. But let's get into this. Join our private investment community here on Facebook, Private Stock Market Game. Make sure you add the community, you know, come learn and grow with us. Also get some of the free 99 plays that I share and just come be a part of the community and learn more. Also, follow me on Twitter at December DeMarco. Make sure you do that. A lot of people are watching the channel and still have not yet followed me on Twitter. I need y'all to go over to Twitter. Make sure you hit that follow button. Now, just some updates in the market. We got from Watcher Guru just in. The number of addresses holding at least 1,000 Bitcoin is now 2,261. It's the highest level in 11 months. So we're starting to see more and more people grab a large amount of Bitcoin and they're holding on to it. So this is almost the highest level it's been in 1 year. We got to connect the dots here, y'all. Something is happening, which we're seeing, you know, that mass adoption. Also, you know, we're seeing a lot of different countries like the Ukraine, you know, using crypto right now. A lot of people are, you know, moving cash or other assets into crypto right now just as a safeguard, you know, from all these sanctions and things that we're seeing. So also just in, sorry to say, Drake has bet $275,000 in Bitcoin on Jorge Masvidal, and he lost it on that fight yesterday, y'all. So I know he's salty about that. Of course, that's probably like, you know, pocket change to him, but you know, that was a pretty confident bet, you know, over $250,000. That's pretty serious. Let me know how would y'all feel if y'all was Drake right now. You know, y'all think he is majorly salty about that, or is he just like, you know, whatever? But you know, we just seen he gave Kodak Black $250,000 in Bitcoin as well. So we are, you know, connecting the dots. Drake is becoming very active in crypto, and he's using it as a form of currency, you know. He's actually using it, so that's good to see as well. So just in, Ukraine has received 75,000 plus donations worth a total of $63.2 million, y'all. Crypto is here to stay. It is not going anywhere. All the other countries and nations and groups are paying attention to how much money the Ukraine raised during this time of need. And trust me, everybody has their little notepads out and they're taking notes. So, you know, everybody, we're going to start to see this happen with every issue that we see, you know, that affects on a global scale. We're going to start seeing NFTs come out to help the causes. We're going to start seeing donations in crypto going to it on a mass level. You know, it's getting crazy, y'all. It's quiet, you know, relatively speaking, versus big catalyst type news right now. But that's just the market. There cannot be major out the park news every single day. It just does not work like that. This is your chance, you know, to check your positions, you know, decide what you want to, you know, load up on before this next major run up. Now, this is not financial advice. Do your own due diligence or whatever works best for you. I'm just giving y'all some insight and how I view things. So also just in, Louisiana has proposed a new bill that would allow crypto donations to political campaigns. That's going to be crazy. So now notice how we got crypto exchanges sponsoring sporting arenas, sports teams, etc. Now we're going to see this move into politics. Now imagine, you know, seeing Coinbase, you know, being the number one donation for the next political or presidential candidate. You know, that's going to be crazy, y'all. We're in a very, very interesting time, you know, and it's exciting to be a part of, you know, the change that's taking place right now. So, you know, we're out here trying to learn as much as possible, make as much money as possible, and, you know, just live life. But also just in, Ankara University will offer an official NFT course. Also, stay tuned. My NFT course will be available soon. We're going to start covering a lot more NFT, you know, information on the channel, news as well, and projects that are upcoming. So that way y'all get the chance to get in early on some of these projects. Let me know your favorite NFT project that you have right now, or just if it's something that you're checking out and you want me to check it out on the channel. Let me know in the comment section. So also, Google searches for NFT and metaverse have dropped 58% and 36% respectively from January. That's a good sign. That means, you know, the interest is, you know, slowing down right now. And when we see that pullback, that's a good time to buy that dip before the next craze and the next hype and the next mass awareness of NFTs starts to spread again. It's gonna happen. NFTs aren't going anywhere, especially if you can get in on some solid projects with solid communities and some solid utility. You know, you should be fine. So also, Malaysia, illegal Bitcoin miners stole electricity worth $550 million, according to the country's government. That's crazy right there. Also, just in, Apple co-founder Steve Wozniak says Bitcoin is the only one that's pure gold mathematics. Crazy. So we can see the co-founder of Apple saying this, how bullish he is on Bitcoin. Y'all got to connect the dots, y'all. Look at your favorite projects, understand what they are, start looking into these other projects, you know, get a better grasp of them, so that way you can be in earlier. But crypto is serious. China's central bank says they'll continue its crackdown on crypto speculation. So that's just some FUD in the market. China does this every couple months. Every 4 months, we hear China say they're banning crypto. Then, you know, next thing you know, they say it's all good. So don't worry about that. That's just part of, you know, the cycles in the market. NASDAQ experts say a crypto market crash is coming. So do I think that is happening or could happen? I do think we could still potentially see a $30,000 Bitcoin, but I don't consider it a crash, because as soon as it touches that level, so many investors and traders, I'll say traders really, are going to buy it up at that point, just because they know that that is super oversold. And they'll try to get, you know, in on a low price like that. So that way, when the price returns to, you know, 40,000 per Bitcoin, 50,000 per Bitcoin, even 60,000, they at least doubled their money. So, you know, that's how it works, y'all. Also, just in, Skybridge Capital founder believes Bitcoin will one day reach 500,000. I agree. I think Bitcoin one day with enough time will be $1 million a coin. Also, just in, NASDAQ experts say a crypto market crash is coming. Okay, we just went over that. Okay, so that's all we got for that. Let's take a look at the market prices right now. We do see prices down for the day. Overall market cap of crypto is at $1.7 trillion, down 3.2% right now. We got Bitcoin down 2.7% at $37,925.18. ETH under that $2,600 mark right now at $2,528, down 3.85%. BNB is at $369.40, down 3% on the day. XRP 72 cents. And as you notice too, a lot of, you know, these updates that I do every day, we check the price, you know, for my traders out there. You can notice the floors or the support levels that we continuously see with some of these coins. So you can just know that if you see BNB under, you know, 375, we know it's going back over 400. So what some traders do, they'll load up on this and then, you know, buy it down here around this range and then wait till it returns to, you know, regular or higher prices and then sell it. The name of the game is buy low, sell high. I generally try to wait for a 10 to 15% discount on my favorite assets and then buy that dip, because that way if it returns right back the next day, you just made a 10 to 15% return on your money ASAP, not even counting the extra percent to go if it goes beyond that point. So, let's see what else we got here. Terra Luna at 79, under $80 for today. It was just at $88 yesterday, down 6.7%. Cardano at 81 cent right now, down 4.3%. Solana at $82, down 5.4% right now. Cardano, y'all, do not sleep on this. 26 new decentralized exchanges are being built on Cardano right now as we speak. The Cardano blockchain is, you know, what that team is over there doing is ridiculous. You know, a lot of people are adapting. We're in the number 8 spot right now. I predict Cardano eventually moving up at least to a number 6, maybe number 5 slot this year. So that's a pretty big prediction to go from 27 billion dollar market cap to take that 6th spot with at least be 34 billion at this point right now, and 52 billion at that number 5 slot. So that's possibly doubling your money, or almost doubling your money if it does do that. So remember, you know, this is speculation. You know, I'm not even doing technical analysis on this. This is just my intuition of the markets, and you know, from what I've seen, SHIB is at 23.14 level right now, down 3.6%. You know, I was doing a little TA on Bitcoin earlier today before this video, just, you know, looking like, you know, what does it look like? And it looks like the price slightly might want to actually rebound a little bit, you know, and go up. But also, I'm going to show y'all that at the end of this video. I want to show y'all or just tell y'all more about how you can make money on days like this when the markets are down, or just if you're not actively trading Shiba Inu, how you can trade something else and make a lot of money in a short period of time. You know, a lot of money is relative to the person, but it's nice. So we got an article here from NBC News, how the Ukraine conflict became a turning point for cryptocurrency. The supposedly borderless form of money has collided with the reality of international sanctions spurred by a major European conflict. Many major cryptocurrency exchanges put forth defiant statements this week when Ukraine asked them to freeze any accounts belonging to Russians, with some exchanges calling upon crypto's history of liberation ideals to back up their decisions. More quietly, however, many were complying with the sanctions plan aimed at devastating the Russian economy. The gap between the world, the words and actions of crypto's biggest players points to the change that the crypto community now faces as a mainstream industry in the midst of a geopolitical and humanitarian crisis, one that now looks like a defining moment for cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin and Ethereum. On the Ukraine side, digital coins have lined up their reputation for easily moving money across international borders, as sympathizers with Ukraine cause Ukrainian cause have raised the equivalent of more than 54 million. So we seen earlier that number's over 60 million now through cryptocurrency donations. But on the Russian side, the supposedly borderless form of money has instead collided with the reality of international sanctions spurred by a major European conflict, and also the moral question of whether participants in the crypto markets could unwittingly help fuel a war of aggression or help Russian oligarchs preserve their wealth. In between cryptocurrency exchanges and Bitcoin hardliners, both of whom have exposed what they say is the libertarian ethos embedded in crypto, have had it to wrestle with tough questions about just how much they want to embrace a technology that critics argue has little practical value aside from money laundering and investment hedging, while requiring huge amounts of electricity and the burning of fossil fuels. And they also had to confront the reality that making crypto into big business means accepting things like international sanctions. There's a libertarian strand that runs through cryptocurrency, but I think the pushback many people in crypto have is against dragnet surveillance and extrajudicial seizures, said Ryan Selkin, CEO of Masari, a crypto research and data firm. We all respect the rule of law and respect the system we're operating under. Crypto in recent years moved from a fringe technology to the kind of mainstream industry that pushes multiple Super Bowl ads from companies backed with hundreds of millions of dollars of investments. The underlying blockchain technology relies on distributed computing power to create public and unbreakable digital ledgers that can track who owns what without a central authority. One question now is how many of crypto's anti-authority streak is still a reality, and how much is carefully chosen marketing slogans? At the start of the sanctions against Russia, one of the most strident statements came from Binance, the world's largest crypto exchange. A Binance spokesperson said that limiting Russians' access to crypto would fly in the face of the reason why crypto exists. But by Friday, Binance CEO CZ was striking a different tone, saying in a 1,500-word blog post that the company applies the same sanction rules as the banks, and noting the fundraising efforts Binance donated $10 million for humanitarian needs. Why won't Binance go one step further and sanction slash freeze all Russian users' assets, Zhao wrote. The most important point, we don't think we have the authority to do so. Other major exchanges have also clarified that they would comply with U.S. and European sanctions, just not go further than the laws require. The U.S. Treasury Department has not accused the exchange of being out of compliance. Experts have said that Russian President Vladimir Putin won't be able to use virtual currency to evade sanctions on a large scale, because even at $2 trillion, the crypto market isn't big enough and crypto exchanges have compliance departments dedicated to catching money laundering. We have a number of sophisticated tool set that allow us to understand who are sanctioned individuals, sanctioned nations, be able to track cryptocurrency and fiat deposits and withdrawals and make sure that we block those users as we have been doing since our inception. Brett Harrison, the president of FTX.us, told CNBC. The reality of virtual currency is different from how early technologists imagined it, as something so powerful that governments could never touch it. Various criminal and foreign elements will be active users of CryptoNet, but this will not halt the spread of crypto anarchy, physicist Timothy May wrote in the Crypto Anarchist Manifesto in 1988, 2 decades before the introduction of Bitcoin made the idea a reality. A fabled outlaw image may once have benefited digital coins by adding to their allure, but that image is now a potentially liability as regulators and lawmakers swarm around the community. Cryptocurrency linked crime hit a record last year, with illegal addresses receiving $14 billion in digital currencies, according to research firm Chainalysis, although that represented 0.15% of total crypto transaction volume. So that's less than 1%. So, this may be a moment for longtime crypto critics to achieve what they wanted, stricter regulation of cryptocurrencies, which they see as an end run around traditional securities market regulation. Senator Elizabeth Warren of Massachusetts this week joined 3 other Democratic senators in sending a letter to Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen, seeking reassurance that Putin wouldn't be able to use coins to evade sanctions. Cryptocurrency can allow financial criminals, drug dealers, and tax cheats to move money around in the shadows, potentially opening the door for Putin and his cronies to evade the economic sanctions that serve as the centerpiece of the international response to Russia's invasion of Ukraine, Warren said in a statement to NBC News. Financial regulators need to address this urgent threat to ensure that crypto doesn't undermine our national security, she said. But the criticism of cryptocurrency has also come from Republicans, adding possible bipartisan momentum to the push for regulation. Cryptocurrency is rearing its ugly head here, Senator Lindsey Graham of South Carolina said this week after a classifying briefing on Russia-Ukraine conflict. He said he was worried about Russians using virtual currency to evade sanctions. Jerome Powell, the chairman of the Federal Reserve and a Republican, has repeatedly called for new U.S. laws to govern the crypto industry, a position that he reiterated Wednesday in a congressional testimony. In defending cryptocurrency, its advocates have emphasized the plight of everyday Russians who had no say-so in Putin's decision to send troops into the Ukraine. If you're a middle-class Russian right now and your entire financial system has been seized and blocked, is it legitimate for you to be able to put 100 or 1,000 of your savings into a crypto hard wallet that you could take with you if you're leaving the country with the clothes on your back, Selkis said? That is something that should be celebrated, he said. It's not clear how many Russians are in that situation, but it's certainly a minority. Russia ranked 18th out of 154 countries last year in Chainalysis report on the grassroots adoption of cryptocurrency, and a more recent report showed Russians have not been flocking to crypto in recent weeks. Worldwide, retail investors in cryptocurrency are increasingly being overshadowed by hedge funds and other institutional firms. So that's a good sign, you know, a good note to keep in mind that retail investors in cryptocurrency are increasingly being overshadowed by hedge funds and other institutional firms. So smart money is in the building, y'all. That institutional money is in the building. The overall effect of the Russia-Ukraine conflict may be to separate crypto myth from reality, something that's been happening already in the past couple years. U.S. authorities have partially unraveled the often repeated crypto mantra that digital coins are unconfiscatable, seizing $3.6 billion in Bitcoin in one confiscation last month. Agents in the case used a search warrant to obtain access to an online account where one of the alleged thieves kept the private keys required to access his digital wallet. People who own cryptocurrency can add layers of security to make government seizures more difficult, including storing their coins offline in a device known as a cold wallet or hard wallet. People can then take those devices around the world. But for Russians who might want to obtain such a device now, even that has become more difficult. We are not delivering into Russia, said Kristina Mazanok, a spokesperson for Satoshi Labs, which says it has sold more than 1 million of its Trezor crypto wallets. She said the company halted shipments immediately after the imposition of sanctions. Satoshi Labs is based in the Czech Republic, where Mazkanov said sympathy for Ukraine runs high. In 1968, the then Soviet Union invaded the country known as Czechoslovakia. Bitcoin is very apolitical, she said. I would like to imagine that Bitcoin is the solution for different situations and that it will stay that way. But she said some company employees have connections to the conflict that make it personal. We are touched by the situation in Ukraine. So that's the end of that article. Just trying to, you know, get y'all minds wrapped around, or, you know, the gears in your mind thinking more about, you know, what lawmakers are saying, what people in political positions are saying, what people in, you know, just more powerful positions are saying, and how you can take that information and, you know, use it as some form of analysis, fundamental analysis maybe, and or incorporate it into your fundamental analysis to make better informed decisions. So we can see here that regulation is coming. You know, a lot of these altcoins, you know, that are just popping up, you know, I'm curious to see, you know, how will these coins, you know, stand this test of time once regulation actually hits, because it's looking like, you know, they're pushing for it. You know, crypto has become accepted. It's become mainstream, like they said, and the government is not just going to sit by and allow people, like they said, to do money, basically use it for malicious purposes. You know, they just showed last month that they were able to seize $3.6 billion in crypto. So it wasn't like they just, you know, were able to hack into the blockchain and take it. It seems that the people they took it from actually had their seed phrase stored on a website that allows you to store passwords or something like that. And the government, with a search warrant, got access to that website, which revealed the seed phrase. And the government basically used the seed phrase to gain access to the wallet and remove the crypto. So that is absolutely crazy. That is why it's very important, you know, for you to make sure you have a cold wallet, hard wallet, whatever. Don't just store your crypto on these central exchanges, or, you know, don't just store your passwords on, you know, some of these other websites, because you can take every step to secure your crypto, but if you put your seed phrase somewhere that, you know, it was easy to access for, you know, a bad actor, you're toast. Your crypto is toast, you're toast. And, you know, I don't want to see that happen to my audience. So also, I wanted to go into quickly just a little look at the SPY, which is the S&P 500. For y'all that are interested in how to make money outside of just trading crypto, you can do what's called trading stock options. I love trading options. This is how I made like my first six figures the fastest, like within a short period of time. I already made six figures before, but in trading, it was through trading options, not through just long-term holding stocks for a long time and waiting for them to blow up. You have to, you know, of course you get those, you know, once you hold. I did very nicely off Tesla. I made a lot of money through Tesla, but you also can make even more money by holding an option contract if the option moves in the direction that you predict the price. So an option is basically, you know, 100 shares bundled up, or, you know, the price of 100 shares bundled up. You get basically, depending on the price action, you have what's called a delta inside your Greeks. And whatever that delta is, it could be, let's say, 54 or 75. If it's a 54, every $1, if you buy a call option, every $1 the price moves in the direction up, you will make $54. So if the price moves $2, you will make $108. So that's an easy way to be able to make a lot of money very quickly. You could easily do $300 to $500 a day doing this. I have a stock options trading course that teaches this and breaks this down even more, teaching you indicators, chart patterns, candlesticks, interpretation, and, you know, how to trade options, how to know how to pick the right strike price, in the money, out of the money. All this information is inside my stock options trading course. So if you like that course, reach out to me via email, decemberdemarco@gmail.com. Also, I have my Crypto 101 course, as well as my technical analysis course, that will break these charts down for you and teach you how to interpret and understand this information 99.9% better than, you know, where you're at right now, or even 100%. I know a lot of people that don't understand the chart at all. They literally jump in and just buy. Maybe if they see a candle green, they might buy because they think that means a green signal to buy, and they're not using any, you know, form of technical analysis or the indicators to make a better informed decision. So in that case, you will be 100% better trader, and you will learn how to actually day trade the correct way through this course. So reach out to me again. That's decemberdemarco@gmail.com. Stock options trading course, crypto one-on-one course, or my technical analysis course. They're all available right now. And I will have my NFT course coming soon. So stay tuned. That's all we got for this video. Appreciate y'all for pulling up. And we are out.